You know, desperate people seem to have short memories. And when they're feeling really desperate, they reach up blindly for solutions to any current problem. This was a view summed up, I thought, pretty accurately by Zwelinzima Mbabazi, the General Secretary of the South African Federation of Trade Unions, when he spoke last week and reiterated the fact that he was apologizing for the mistake he'd made in leading what turned out to be the Zuma tsunami that toppled President Thabo Mbeki. He said that AIDS denialism had fueled this desire for change. But then, in their desperation, he and others chose the most compromised person only because he was brave enough to take on Thabo Mbeki. Well, that has been said before. But Mbabazi was using this as an illustration of what he sees as the hero worship of Cyril Ramaphosa, the deputy president, currently, especially after Davos. This personification, this personality politics, he sees, and I think he's probably correct, as the core of the problem. He referred to the people supporting Cyril Ramaphosa, calling themselves buffalo soldiers, similar to the tsunami, the Zuma tsunami. And, of course, they also tend to refer, those who are critical, to the deputy president as Mac Buffalo, a reference to the fact that he owns the McDonald's fast food franchise, and that he once bid 18 million rand for a buffalo for one of his game farms. But the underlying argument, quite simply, is that there can be no messiah to cure the leprous economy or somehow lift the poor and downtrodden onto some road, some path to collective salvation. That this cannot happen, this will not happen, and we're making yet another mistake by personifying things. That at the same time, we have people like George Soros, Open Society Foundation, etc., the billionaire philanthropist, talking about looking for solutions in state capture, corruption, and populist leaders have to be taken on. Yet these are merely symptoms, I think, of exactly the same problem. We have to look to the cause, and the cause, I think, is the ongoing economic crisis, which is continuing to impoverish the many at the expense, not of the few, but at the enrichment of the few. And it's not going to go away, not in any short term or medium term or even long term, I fear. We have artificial intelligence, algorithms that are rapidly replacing human labor. That's part of that problem. Yet at the same time, this very problematic development, technological advancement, has the potential to liberate all of humanity. It's quite simple. That's the essence of the problem, and it contains the answer within it. And I think it's time for all of us to recognize this fact and to start to deal with how we move ahead, how we change the system which is misusing these incredible developments. Anyway, that will be the focus of my Inside Labour column, which you can access as usual on this platform, FIN24, tomorrow, and a version of which will appear in the City Press business section on Sunday. Until then, once again, over to you. Comments, criticisms, etc. I know many of you have got my personal email, but please don't send them to me. Send them instead to editor@fin24.com. That's editor@fin24.com. I'll still reply to them. And until next week, that's all from me. Cheers.